There's no need to fear. Underdog is here.
When criminals in this world appear.
And land in reality, Chief Little Flower, coming at you from the privacy and safety of my beloved benefactor's estate and sanctuary. So, this is my new set of videos called Coinciding Incidents, because as a targeted individual, the opposition comes up with a lot of psychological weaponized tools of abuse and torture that the Zetzer song that the Nazi heritage had trained their little flying flunky monkeys to enact, to sell out their soul for, to become minions of Satan himself. A lot of these people call themselves Christian, go to church by day, and then go target their individuals with their psycho stage theater. So whenever a targeted individual is asked, so what's the deal about being targeted? There are countless numbers of gaslighting events that it's kind of difficult just to call them up on a roster. So the purpose of coinciding events is that a lot of times whenever the trained flying flunky monkeys that often parade themselves as backstabbing Christians when they're really Team Judas, what it is that they'll contrive these incidents that they were trained to do by their handlers, which are actual pedophiles and murderers. They ain't got no problem consorting with pedophiles and murderers, you know? So whatever. But I am terming this coinciding incidents because it's exactly what it is. These are double entendres that infiltrate the atmosphere just to needle the targeted individual, just to needle them act out of sorts. So a lot of times it is just happenstance, and a lot of times it is purposeful psycho stage theater. That this is your melee for pay. That they got their little hands grubbed to come out and act out these ways toward their targeted individual and pretend they ain't doing fucking shit because they've already compromised their soul and their mind and now have been hand trained to be groomed as the Auschwitz executioners doing their torture, their psychological havoc, their psychological needling of the individual. And it's throwing their rocks and hiding their hands. It's backstabbing and pretending they didn't throw a goddamn knife. So whenever these events come up, yeah, they just might be happenstance of a coinciding event that happened in the background of the atmosphere. And honestly, I really don't care if it's a actual contrived psycho theater or if it really is a coinciding event that just happened organically. Whenever it comes up, this is what my videos are. And this is what this portion of these files are about. So I'm just going to start relating them as I remember them. So welcome to my coinciding events file. And so enjoy the throwing of the rocks and the hiding of the hands. Yes, is it really psycho theater or is it really an organic coinciding event? Either way, I don't care. I'm here to report the information as I recall it or as it plays out. Because at the end of the day, only God knows. Thank you for watching. Enjoy the story.
Hey, so this particular coinciding incident, oh my God, it was so fucking funny. You know,
the adage is, if you want to get over like the fear or something, the best way to do it is to repeatedly do it until you no longer feel the fear. So it's kind of like feel the fear and do it anyway. For me, it was belly dance. Get up and express yourself through the movement of one of the dance combinations. Well, I can get up in front of an audience and do whatever it is I need to do, right? I mean, first off, when you're a targeted individual, you're always on some kind of motherfucking stage. And so it's killing. Okay. But also when it comes to persecution, and I mean, also I have like, I love Kuan Yin of I Have No Cut Cards, Tarot. I love her so much. And she mentioned this also with regards to persecution. You know, you can't happen that it, you cannot help that it happens to you. And I'm like, okay. So after a while, it's the same thing. You just don't fucking care anymore. Especially when you walk with the Most High and you know for damn sure that you are so protected. What does it matter? You know, whenever you see friends and loved ones that you loved give in to the temptation of accepting bribes to run the psyop game on you, you're like this, oh, et tu, Brute? Okay, now I know what page you are on and that you've sold out. All right, whatever, I see you. So it's kind of like, well, you made your stance when I'm on my 3D throne. To you too, honey. So when it comes to betrayal, it happens so much, you're just all like, you, whatever. And then when it comes to the persecution and all of this Zetzer song, you're kind of like, really? I was hoping you've moved beyond that for your own mortality and your own salvation. You're kind of like, whatever. So today, which brings me to this coinciding incident for today, I come upstairs because I brought in, you know, a bag or whatever from downstairs, and I sat it on the bed, and I had this preemptive, it was this palpable energy in the air, right? And then, so check it out. Whenever I just happen to turn my gaze over here. So, okay, see, there's a window there, right? Well, in the window. I think it was at that house. The ops was there mean mugging me. Oh, my God. I mean, there's a targeted individual. You know when somebody's mean mugging you, like, what you gonna do about it? What you gonna do? You know, and so I accidentally see him mean mugging me over there, all puffed out like, yeah, yeah, when you look at me, I'm all like, how long you been standing there for? I mean, you, this is what your life has become? That, you're looking to get rich and get payments off of being the goddamn Zetzer son? Really? I mean, I told you, I am being targeted by those close to me. And so that guy was new. I hadn't seen him before. But, you know, I just all like, how long were you standing there waiting for me to notice you? And I'm all like, Pepe Le Pew thinks he's a bulldog. Okay, whatever. He was wearing one of the flannel shirts that was like white and black, right? But, which, coincidingly, my cousin brought in that same color of flannel for her home decor. See, check it out. And then so,
you know, like I mentioned before, she puts down like towels in the past. The towels that she usually had used were like the same or similar to the towels at my dead mother's house. But this particular decor, which I thought was really nice, she just put that there like yesterday or the day before. This is a new addition. And then so she was a little frustrated because when you walk on it, you know, it slides around. So I, you know, put some duct tape underneath it. And the coinciding incident is that the dude was over there. I guess somewhere on that side of the fence, one of those two houses mean mugging me. And then one time over in, I think it was somewhere in Seattle, it was over in Washington. You know, I mean, my truck was my genie's pod, right? And so I was looking down, I don't know what it was I was looking at, and I just arbitrarily had looked up, and across the way was this dude. And then it was like he was wearing like a Jason mask or something, all standing there with that stance like, I'm about to run off and head towards somebody. You know, with the fucking mask on. And I'm all just all like, when I looked up arbitrarily, so I'm standing there, I'm all like, I started busting out laughing because you were waiting for all this time for me to notice you. And that's what your life has become. And you have no shame in that. And you probably are even proud of it. I'm all like, okay. And just so that dude across the way over there at the other side of that fence, I'm just all like, oh my God, how long were you standing there waiting for me to notice you? That fucking shit is hilarious. I don't care who you are. It's fucking hilarious. I'm all like lamoid over there. I mean, honestly, they're looking to catalyze oppression and suppression. What they did was just fucking monitor a goddamn comedy show. I mean, and that right there was the same fucking pattern flannel shirt the man was wearing. I mean, I've got more coinciding incidences, but I thought I would just let up on the gas pedal on that. I mean, it's because, first off, this is where you have to be loyal to the truth and to the data, not to people. You know, because my job as a targeted individual, I take on the stance of being the psychological, sociological anthropologist while I'm being, you know, heavily targeted and everything. I'm more like an anthropologist. Well, this time's got a baby holder. I love it whenever the puppy dogs carry the babies. You got the baby, honey. This time you got the baby holder. Oh my God, they're so cute. They're so cute. He got a baby. And then Antioch, the little one, will try to take this. Hello, hello, hello. I'm trying to take the baby from him. And they're running upstairs. They're so fucking cute. I mean, I'm their pet sitter. But my cousin, you know, I mean, I love her to death. And, you know, that's my role in her household is to take care of those little puppies. So, you know, I give them the best treatment. So it's kind of like Florence Nightingale showing up to take care of the creature. So in a way, I'm also like Cinderella. And again, no matter where I am in life, I'm going to do my best in my role. Now, do I deserve to be Cinderella? Fuck no! I'm a goddamn paramedic that was making differences in people's lives, but I'm like, you know what? I'm very grateful to have a place of shelter where I'm not out in the trenches at large in that fucking frying pan. I'm in, like, the side dish frying pan right now. And while I'm here, I'm just going to try to evangelize everybody that's on the wrong side of tracks, the train tracks. So whatever, you know, I'm like, okay, because at the end of the day, promotion comes from the Most High. And if this is where he has me, I'm going to be the best in the role of wherever I end up, you know? So, you know, if I'm going to, my cousin doesn't expect me to pick up the dog excrement outside. She does that when she gets home from work. But if I'm outside and it's a beautiful day, I mean, I'm going to chip in and do that, because the woman works two jobs, you know? I mean, I'm very grateful to be able to take care of the puppy dogs, you know? And if it means picking up the poopy every once in a while, so what? Even though I have a whole fucking homestead that's being kept for me, and I have a whole inheritance in the 3D that these assholes are squatting in my life, I'm all like, you know what? Even though there are public servants out there that could make headway and be accountable for the positions of authority instead of just waving it around as a goddamn bloody do-gooder without doing the good, without being extraordinary and coming up with extraordinary problem-solving solutions to get me into my proper position. All that's on them. And it's so, they're going, they will rue the day they decided not to do a goddamn thing about it whenever the Most High and my ancestors come to avenge me for all of their fuck shit, for all of their irresponsibility with being unaccountable to their own positions of authority that they, you know, don't use accordingly, you know, so whatever. But yeah, I'm all like, the coinciding incidents continues to rack up, you know, and so I'm just all like, I held off on it, but I mean, there I go, kind of being loyal to people instead of to the data, because while I am the anthropologist in the mix of all of this, I decode this shit so fucking easy. It's kind of like, okay, now you guys are really running your dick into the ground, because what the Holy Spirit is doing and the ancestors is that you're playing with people's lives with the intention of causing death. So, you know, if you don't stop, they're just going to take you out with death. And it's already been announced in the ether. So I'm just all like, okay. If me, as the person in your fucking face, with, you know, alluding to, hey, I fucking know, hello, handlers, you're really going to just teach the children how to just government grub and gold dig instead of actually being upright and holding on to integrity at every temptation, you're teaching them to buy into the temptation. You're teaching them how to be parasites and how to give up their soul, my loves. You need to stop that. You know I still love you anyway. So that's kind of like, okay, whatever. But I haven't had such a fucking awesome laugh and such a good hearty while. I mean, I laugh every day, sure. But like that, I'm all like, thank you. Don't do it again, because each time you do, you're just going to dig a worse grave for yourself, so whatever. But anything that's ever thrown at me, I make the best of, so whatever. I'll tell you guys about another coinciding incident another time where I laughed as fucking hard. But I have to say, the incident with the dude wearing like the Jason kind of mask over and watching his stand in there, it was kind of like this. You know, I'd imagine if I could see his face beyond the mask, I'd be like, he was just standing there. I'm all like, How long were you standing there waiting for me to notice you? I'm all like, these people are fucking crazy. I mean, they'll gold dig for anything and do fucking anything. I mean, like this guy across the other side of the fence that just happened to be wearing the same fucking flannel pattern as the goddamn new rug that was brought in. This makes the third day it's been here. I mean, I'm all like, how long was he standing there waiting for me to notice him? I mean, it's really demonic. I mean, it is demonic and everything, but whatever. So, you know, pick it up, judicial, to your own detriment or not, because, I'm still being psyoped and I should not even be in any atmosphere that is capable of running any fucking psyop. Plausible deniability. I mean, okay, handlers, have fun this Sunday or maybe this Friday if you're off on your fucking psychotic handling show, because the dude that was like a goddamn gang stalker over at the Highway 6 RV resort where I was staying at, he would have Zoom meetings. Do you guys all have Zoom meetings and then discuss how you guys are going to rail your targets with the other handlers? Because the Holy Spirit can see you guys do that, and they're over there listening in on your all of your like dastardly ways of trying to come up with, to contrive how to come at your fucking steak so you can squeeze it for the last fucking turnip and get that blood coin, you know. So whatever, you're doing your dirty money. Okay, while you all destroyed the future of the children around you, it's kind of nice to have that pattern broken up where somebody's home in the morning time and then we'll go in later and everything. I'm like, you know what? Do your crazy ass templates and your new fucking patterns. I just stay the fuck out of them. You know, I'm just all like, Dios mío. It's like watching a psyop version of the Pink Panther trying to run the fucking game on the goddamn target that fucking can see through everything and even see it before you even play it and even see it run across your eyes right before you go get permission to go into my bedroom and then plant shit that wasn't there before. Like, I've never seen that. Shit, I can see it play in your fucking noggin. Whatever. But nonetheless, it's Patricia and Landon Regali. Cheap little flower coming at you from the privacy, the safety, and the sanctuary of some house in North Carolina running the Zetzer song with the neighbor across the way and the coinciding incident with the new fucking house mat that was brought in. Like, this is like the third day here. That's just a coinciding incident, isn't it? Fucking freaks. I love you fucking freaks. Little rat guy.
You know, and notably speaking, whenever I wake up in the morning, I let the little one out of his sleeping crate, I developed a pattern of peeking in my cousin's room to see if Nagua is there, because whenever she'd gone out of town, the cat had gotten trapped inside her room with the door closed, and I don't rifle through people's stuff, and if the door is closed, I'm just going to mosey on with my business. But after 2 days, I'm all like, where's the cat? Because the cat's more like an outdoor cat. And I keep up with it because, you know, I'm Florence Nightingale taking care of these little fur babies. I do like to do a bang up job. But what I did notice is the lovely pattern. Oh, sorry, honey. Sorry. And then so, you know, again, it's just a coinciding incident. So whenever I poked my, you know, my peepers around the corner of the bedroom to see if, Nagua is there or not, because, he gets taken to another house where he has play dates, like every Wednesday and Saturday. So I just like to make sure that I am aware of the head counts of the fur babies in the house. And I don't know how long that pattern blanket has been on the bed, but as far as I can tell, it's rather new too. So again, coinciding incidents. I'm like, whatever.